Danny Merrill, I want to discuss with you briefly the stamp of the Antichrist. This is a very important subject, and you should understand it. The next Bible prophecy to be fulfilled is what we refer to as the rapture, or the catching up into the clouds to meet Jesus Christ, all true believers worldwide in Him by the billions. And after the rapture, then the man who's referred to as the Antichrist will be manifested. And one of the first order of business will be to see that everybody has a stamp on their right hand or in their forehead, because he is going to tell the world on national television, international television, that aliens have invaded the world and have taken the millions of people, billions of people that have disappeared. So therefore, to detect who is an alien and who is not an alien, he is going to issue a worldwide stamp to be put on the hand, the right hand, or in the forehead of each and every person. The problem is, once you receive that stamp, you are condemned. That stamp will allow you to buy, sell, and work. But that stamp also guarantees you that you will be thrown into the lake of fire and brimstone forever. And I want to read you three verses from Revelation chapter 14, verse 9. Then another angel, a third, followed them, saying with a mighty voice, "Whoever pays homage to the beast and his statue, and permits the beast's stamp, mark, inscription to be put on his forehead or on his hand," verse 10, "he too shall have to drink of the wine of God's indignation and wrath, poured undiluted into the cup of his anger, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb." Verse 11, "And the smoke of their torment ascends forever and ever, and they have no respite, no pause, no intermission, no rest, no peace, day or night, these who pay homage to the beast and to his image, and whosoever receives the stamp of his name upon him." Now, I want to be very clear. Barack Obama, the current president of the United States, is not the Antichrist. The Pope of Rome is not the Antichrist. The Antichrist will come out of the European common market. Now, when you look at world population and Muslim demographics, the Muslims are taking over the entire world. And if they take over Europe in the next several years, and a Muslim was elected to be the head of the European common market, then that would explain the mark of the beast or the Antichrist, because he, after the rapture, and he becomes the head of the European common market, then he's going to issue an order to stamp the right hand of every human being on earth and their forehead. I suspect that if the Muslims take over the world, that the mark will be the mark of the crescent of the moon, and the mark of the head in the head will be the crescent of the moon, because Islam worships the demonic moon god named Allah. This is very serious business. Now, if you're listening to my voice, I'm going to ask you to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. I am sure that you would not want your wife, your girlfriend, your son, your daughter, your grandchildren, or friends to receive this mark, because they're going to be cast into the lake of fire and brimstone for all eternity for having that mark. However, if you receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and your family and friends would receive Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, they won't be here. They will be caught up in the rapture. They won't have to be confronted whether they will take the mark or not. So you will escape the mark of the beast, and you will escape being thrown into the lake of fire and brimstone. I'm not asking you to send me money. I'm not asking you to join my church. I'm asking you to receive Christ as your Savior. He died on the cross, shed divine blood to pay for your sins. He rose from the dead, flesh and bone, 3 days later, and he ascended to the right hand of God the Father in heaven, where he is now. And he invites you to come to him by faith. Pray this prayer out loud with me to the living Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, I confess to you that I am a sinner. I come to you by faith. I ask that you accept your divine blood that you shed for me at the cross to pay for all of my sins. On the basis of that blood, forgive me, Jesus Christ. I ask that your representative on earth at this time, the person of God the Holy Spirit, would come into my heart and into my life. I receive you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Savior and my personal Lord. In your name, Jesus Christ, amen.